Good morning. In this video, I am going to teach derive Stern-Volmer equation. Stern-Volmer equation tells us about intermolecular deactivation of physical reaction. That is, photophysical reactions are for fluorescence and phosphorescence. These are fluorescence and phosphorescence intramolecular deactivation physical process. Here we are discussing intermolecular deactivation of fluorescence. So here intermolecular deactivation of electronically excited molecule, that is nothing but Stern and Volmer. They worked on the same concept. They gave an equation. They derived some equation. So that equation mainly the depends on quenching. Quenching is a process which competes with the spontaneous emission and thereby shortens the lifetime of emitting by adding chemical substances. The substances that bring about quenching, that is also known as quencher. So the kinetic scheme for quenching is first equation, light interacts with molecule, formation of electronically excited molecule. This electronically excited molecule with emission of with K0F M, it releases heat radiation, that is called H wave. And third step, M star, summation of KI M, all other pathways. And fourth one, this M electronically excited state interacts with Q. Q is nothing but quencher, and the energy is absorbed by quencher. So this is KQ M plus Q star. This is the kinetic scheme for quenching, that is collisional quenching, that is also known as intermolecular deactivation of photophysical reactions. So the rate equation, this is rate KVS, K absorption step, this is emission step. So this is this is also emission, but all other pathways, but this is in presence of quencher, how it abstracts the energy from electronically excited molecule. So short is the lifetime of electronically excited state molecule by adding quencher. So rate equation, rate is equal to KABS, concentration of M, intensity of H nu. Here also rate is equal to K0F, concentration of M star. Here R is equal to summation of KI, concentration of M star. Here rate is equal to concentration of M star and concentration of Q. This is rate equations. According to our definition, quantum yield for fluorescence, rate of emission by rate of absorption. So first step is the absorption step, second step is the emission step. So quantum yield phi f is equal K naught F concentration of M star divided by K ABS concentration of M intensity of H nu. This is equation 1. So in equation, the quantum yield for fluorescence depends on concentration of M star. So SSP applicable to concentration of M star. So rate equation of concentration M star is dP is equal to, in first step it is formed, in these three steps it is consumed. So the cap, it is in first step it forms, it carries positive term. In three equations, in three steps it consumes, it carries the rate equations, that is negative charges. So we should write like this: concentration KABS, concentration of M, concentration of H, intensity of H2 minus K0F, concentration of M minus K, summation of KI, concentration of M star minus KQ, concentration of M star and Q. This is equal to equation equal to 0 to, that is equation 2. From equation 2, the concentration, that is KABS, concentration of M, intensity of H nu is equal to concentration of K0F, concentration of M star and plus summation of KI, concentration of M star plus KQ, concentration of m and concentration of q. This is we got from equation 2. Here in three terms concentration of m star is common, so we can take commonly, that is concentration of m star. Totally we want concentration of m star is equal k abs concentration of m intensity of h nu divided by k naught f plus summation of ki plus kq into concentration of q. Here since k naught f plus summation of ki is equal summation of ki prime, so the equation will become above equation concentration m star will become k abs concentration of m h nu intensity of h nu divided by summation of ki prime plus kq into concentration of q. This is equation 3. Equation 3 substitute in equation 1 from equation 3 substitute in equation 1. So quantum yield for fluorescence is equal to k abs concentration k0f concentration of m intensity of h nu divided by summation of ki prime plus kq into concentration of q into k abs concentration of m intensity of h nu. So kbs and kbs mutually cancels, so finally quantum yield for fluorescence is equal k0f by summation of ki prime plus kq into concentration of q. This is equation 4. So in presence of quencher, in absence of quencher, the quantum yield for fluorescence is denoted as phi 0f is equal k0f summation of ki. So in absence of kq concentration of kq into q is equal to 0. In absence of quencher, so this is equation 5. So equation 5 divided by equation 4, so quantum yield for fluorescence in absence of quencher divided by quantum yield for fluorescence is equal k naught f by summation of ki into summation of ki prime plus kq into concentration of q by k0f mutually cancels, so the equation will become equation is phi naught f by phi f is equal summation of ki prime plus kq by concentration of q divided by summation of ki prime. So this equation can be written as phi a naught f by phi f is equal to summation of ki prime by summation of ki prime plus kq by summation of ki prime into concentration of q. Summation of ki prime cancels and summation of ki prime mutually cancels, so we will get final equation, that is quantum yield for fluorescence is absence of quencher, in presence of quencher is equal to 1 plus kq summation of ki prime concentration of q. So since that is kq by summation of ki is equal ksv. Ksv means rate constant for Stern-Volmer equation. So it becomes quantum yield for quantum phi f is equal 1 plus ksv into concentration of quencher. This is equation Stern-Volmer equation. This Stern-Volmer equation gives the relationship intermolecular deactivation of fluorescence. Thank you.